Shout out. Hello.
Shout out.
Hello. Shout out.
Hey, what's up? Happy birthday, Eric.
Yo.
Happy birthday, guys.
What do you have for the wife? Happy birthday. Jim.
Happy birthday.
Shout out.
Happy birthday.
Birthday shout out. Let's go.
Yo, yo, yo. My man. Good guy. No, he's unbelievable. I mean, look at him. Shit. Family up on the portrait.
So,
beautiful. Family's still here. Everybody's still here. So, it's lovely. Happy birthday.
What are we doing?
Drinking, bro.
Hey, hey, what's going on? Hey.
2010. CPI. Sacrifices roast. The man's 30 years old. Old as hell. About to get in his ass real quick. That's my pops. 30 years before now, came out of his nut. That's what it was. That's what it is.
Birthday shout out.
What up, man? LA Fresh now. You know, big lady dog. What's up, man?
Birthday shout out.
What's up, man? I'm just surprised you made it this far. I'm really not that funny right now. Wait, come back in an hour.
I hate looking into a camera because I go like cross-eyed. I'm just gonna act like I'm talking to the guy behind me. Yeah, man, he's a great kid. We had a great time together. Come back in an hour.
We'll be back in an hour. Birthday shout out. Birthday shout out.
Happy birthday.
Birthday shout-out. Birthday shout-out.
What? Eric, I loved looking at the back of your head for 15 minutes the first time I met you. It was so fun.
You my nigga, dog. You my nigga.
Birthday shout-out.
You gotta say something.
Oh, someone hiding from the camera. Birthday shout-out.
What did I say?
Oh.
Pump the fist.
Holla at your boy, you're about to push the shit out of these niggas. Hey, you guys are here about a year and a half ago with D Circuit. And we decided, hey, we're gonna come back and be pretty good, so we made a ritual that one of the men turned 30, hey, so ass. So, tonight we get on, you eat, not only because it's your birthday, but because you're gonna make you start out with nothing, and you got most of it left. So, we have
Man, you
Evil the Warrior, Tony Parker. I mean, after that, it's like, I don't know. I asked him one day, man, how'd you know Mary left us for you? He said, Alex, man, I love being married. There's less in the world than what there is. And you look across the group of them, and you look in their eyes, and then you say, you know, that you found that one special person that you want to annoy for the rest of your life.
Yeah. because you know the super cop song, because nobody locks that door. Okay? So he comes home, he decides that the door's locked. Now, rather than doing the smart thing, as in going ahead and letting us know, listen, let me get on the phone, let me text my brothers, hey, listen, you know, I've been out doing some crazy shit tonight, maybe you should open the door for me. This dumb motherfucker decides he's going to ring the doorbell.
What he do?
So he hits the doorbell. My room, Chris and Addison, the time I'm upstairs in the top room, the street floor to my house. So he's sitting there walking. My dad comes to the door. Now, allegedly, I wasn't there, so when I'm telling the story second hand, he says, she says, like, shit. Right? So I don't really know what happened, but this is what I like to think actually happened. He came home, ran the door up. My dad comes and he opens the door. He looks at my dad, realizes, oh, shit, super cop, just opened the door, and maybe, just maybe, I'm not in a condition to walk in right after. Okay? So he walks in through the door and he decides that he's going to reach into his pocket and he's going to pull out his telephone. Well, when he decides to pull out his telephone, he then happens to pull out the telephone and drop.
Thank you.
Facebook, it says, "Push every year to single." But right above that comes up, "Stephen Wright, single." So I'm thinking to myself, I'm like, yeah, maybe, just maybe he's actually gay, right? And they broke up with their girlfriends to be together with each other. So I'm like, damn, that's fucked up. You know what I mean? Like, damn, well, how am I supposed to deal with one of my brothers, one of my baby brothers, being gay? So I was like, okay, let me see. Let me get to the bottom of this. So I went to this song. And I picked up the song. This one, Chris had the phone. All right, this one, that was paying for Chris's phone. So Chris had the phone, and I scooped up the phone, and I looked at the phone, and I was like, okay, let me read out. Let me hit read out and see who he was talking to. So I hit read out, and the name Steven came up.
Who are you lying to?
So I'm like, hey, I'm like, wait a minute. Steven came up. I'm like, hey. So it wasn't that they had broken up with their girlfriends to get together. It's the fact they had broken up with each other. All right? And the funny part is, I don't know about any of y'all who actually been to school. Does anybody know what foreshadowing is? Yeah. Foreshadowing, yeah? God damn, I'm not much about it. I'm an educated ass nigga. This school, I'm going to tell you what foreshadowing is. Foreshadowing is when you kind of tell somebody something about the future, but you don't actually tell them. So I'm thinking to myself, like, all right, cool. You know, maybe, just maybe this is not gay. So then he fucks around, and he brings home a girl who just so happened to be purple. And when I say purple, I mean like this black girl. And you know, like, black girl, like, same face, and she looked at him, and he would be mulatto, but he would claim as he was black. So this bitch is purple.
Let's go!
All right, so here's the thing, right? guy right here, you throw him on your fucking brain right now. If you didn't know him before he had to get the shit about to let you know what he was like. Alright? So we're gonna take E.
Get him.
Like I said, this is Eric, this ain't E23. Okay? So one day Sarah was working a double. Actually, she wasn't working a double. She was going to school and working full time at the same time. Now everybody who's actually done that knows that shit is super stressful. So when she came home, she was a super stressful girlfriend. Okay? So one day, actually this is a funny story, this is actually kind of surprising to E23. Right? So one day she comes home, it's me, Ian, and Alice. We sit down, we listen to our favorite song. Do you think I love you, Mary Jane? So we're listening to our song, we're listening to our favorite song, right? And we're about to play Jeopardy. Alice is back to say, mom, we're about to start the first Jeopardy round, he's introducing everybody in the school. All of a sudden, I hear the door kick in super hard. Boom! I'm like, oh shit, what the hell is that, right? Wait, I'm not sure. So she kicks in the door, boom! Sounds like we're about to get laid, right? And then here's boom, 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 boom. It's funny, all the moves, right? It was like two steps. But she was slamming her arm twice. All this out, right? So she hits, so this, right? She hits the top, she hits the top of the steps. And she just shoots an eye at E. And she just hits her with the evil eyes. And I know all you girls in here know what that evil eyes are. She hits her with the evil eyes, right? And then rolls the eyes. You already know this guy's crazy. You can't look at us and roll your eyes when others get pissed off. Because we're like, what the fuck did I do? So we're sitting there chilling, and she kicks the door, she comes flying upstairs, she gives E a look, and then rolls her eyes. Mm. That's what she said, mm. And she rolls her eyes, right? So now she gets upset. So now everybody, me, Alex, and E know that she's upset, right? So she rolls her eyes and she starts scanning, like any woman would, from left to right. And she's not scanning to make sure everything's in place. She's trying to find something to fucking bitch about when she got home. So she's going from left to right, and she's like, okay, well, the nigga didn't clean up the table. And dishes ain't done, and this nigga's been home all day, right? So she gonna turn to E and be like, baby, like I said, in a nice voice, but you know how girls are, they assholes when they try to be nice about it. So she's just like, baby, I thought I asked you to do the dishes. So E's sitting there on the couch, we about to play, like I said, ask your parents already up, and he already gave all the categories, we about to get into some judgment. And our family, we love us some judgment. All right, we don't hang out a bunch of smart niggas, we know a lot about nothing. Okay, so Jeffrey is a fun-ass guy. So he's up there, and he's about to, you know, he's trying to pay attention to this girl, because this girl came home stressed out, had a long ass day, and he's trying to watch Jeffrey at the same time. So he's sitting there, and she's just like, well, I thought I asked you to do the dishes. So he's like, well, damn, I'm going to do the dishes after Jeffrey didn't give me a second. So Sarah gets upset, she steps back, she looks, and she's like, well, damn, nigga, you've been home all day, I've been at work, blah, 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 you know, I say blah, 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 because every guy in here knows where you're off the fucking wall. Okay, so it's blah, 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 blah. You should have done that shit before I got here, right? Now, any man in front of his people ain't gonna sit there and take that from his woman. So he got up, small chest.
Small chest,
actually, let me show the only kind of thing is this. But he gets up, like, he's tall, so he's a little more intimidated. Right now, I'm not that intimidated because I'm kind of short, but I can't see it because I'm on stage, but I'm a little bit. So, what is Benjamin Franklin? I'm thinking to myself, like, wait a minute, I know this nigga ain't playing Jeopardy. sure as hell can't hear. So I'm thinking to myself, what can I do to get myself out of this situation? So I think to myself, okay, well, I'm going to try to escalate the situation, not de-escalate the situation. I think if I can get these two motherfuckers to fight hard enough, then maybe, just maybe, they'll start fighting this fight, and I can just swing out the back door. Besides talking about paying rent, I mean, I don't know about y'all, but you know, man, I don't know, man, I ain't got it. I'm just like, right? So they're sitting there, and they arguing, so I'm like, damn, what can I do? I'm like, okay, let me try to get involved. Then I realized they were getting real angry. So I'm like, you know what, I'm not going to get involved. Then out of nowhere, I see Eric just starting to crumble. Like, he's arguing with his girl, and the whole argument is going against him, so he's just starting to crumble. He's, like, slowly just moving towards the couch, like, damn, I didn't know what to say, she got me. And then he, in a straight fear of panic, jumps up, and he's like, well, at least I don't shit myself during sex.
He proposed.
So Adam starts jumping around. He's like, oh, God damn, like, whoa. Alex is like, so, congratulations. And he's pissed off. He's looking like he done lost a fight. And had to, you know, thought he was going to leave. Him and his girl won't break up. He lost a fight. So he just threw up a mouth problem. Don't think they know what we're going to have. Fucking like, you go out there and be like, baby, we're mad. You know what? Like I said, he done break said that she should pay for their fuck. I actually got shit draws, and he went and talked to me. Now that shit's all forgiven. So I'm sitting here thinking to myself, like, damn, like, I should go and get a ring and hold that shit on the side just in case I fuck around and get myself a demon hole. All right? But that was the beginning of E.3. Now, E.3, I like to call him E.3 because at this point, he just decided he was going to get married. And from the point where he decided to get married to the point where he impregnated Sarah, we're kind of like Casey, you know, you can tell that he was fighting. There's turmoil, in a turmoil. I mean, he's like, I love her, and I want to be with her, but I don't know if I can spend the rest of my life with her. So I'm thinking to myself, like, why the fuck did you propose to her? I'm thinking to myself, okay, well, if you didn't know if you could be with her the rest of your life, why did you propose to her? And he just looked at me, he was like, Ron C. Bain, she backed me in the corner, dog. He was like, she backed me in the corner, and I was losing the argument, so I just pulled up the ring, and made everything better. Which made sense, because when Alex was like, congratulations, he was laying on the couch and he looked at me and was like, all pissed off and shit, right? So that's the story of how they ended up getting engaged. Okay, so now they're together, that's what's going on. Now, Sarah decides she's going to move to Philly. Sarah moves to Philly, he's still living in Lowell, they're still doing their thing, she comes over, starts doing whatever, you know, but what couples do, they see each other for a while, so they don't think about their state, right? Well, he ain't careful enough, fucks around and actually makes a fucking baby. So he makes a baby, and I remember he comes to me, I still remember the same day, he comes up to me, and he's all super excited, like a new dad, he's like, hey, listen, we're pregnant. And I'm thinking to myself, like, oh shit, like, Sarah's pregnant. But he said, like, we're pregnant, and the worst part about it was that he believed it, because the next 9 months, as Sarah was getting ready with another human being, this motherfucker right here put on, like, 80 pounds. Okay, you see these both? This ain't all the shot.
Sex.
my brother and my sister-in-law. But I just want to let you know, man, I love you to death. I'm sorry for being your brother. Happy birthday, man, and thank you for everybody.
Thank you.
motherfucker. Still looking like Paul Home the Bones game after you. Yeah, don't worry, guys. We're not gonna have the roast fucking. Alex, how old are you? 28. And you're still fucking working security at the mall, huh? This is the only dude I know who calls himself after he steals from Macy's. But Alex always says, though, man, I got my pride, at least I got my pride, man. But what he doesn't tell you is that his pride gets a minimum wage and no vagina. Not even a little bit. Mall security, huh? Fucking unbelievable. All I can picture is teenage girls running from you while you're on your Segway. Chasing them like a fucking pedophile and wicked witch.
I picture my bridges.
Oh, you hear me? But instead of dip, 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 all you hear is this while he's chasing him on his second. You get the point. You get the point. Hey, you better stop chasing little girls in the mall, Alex. I'm telling you. You would get raped so much in prison, you'd have to take the activity challenge every day for a year. No! Still like
it. Oh, you're fired.
That's all right.
I just been crying all over
hey,
the world.
Hey, Alex, I know. I know you think you're the ladies' man, but come on. This prick gets rejected more than D's debit card. Little Jose, I don't know any players that apologize to a chick on Facebook. In front of, and you do know we can read it, right? Yes, my friend, we can. D, the other ladies, man, or Quagmire I Rahina. But instead of giggity, his catchphrase is, yo, you think I can borrow $5? Or, I don't know what you're talking about, girl, and I'm pretty sure it's not mine. Yeah. D's idea of having more than one income is dating three girls with jobs. He's got a good one now, though. He's got a good one. She's very beautiful. Very beautiful. I asked her last name earlier because I wasn't sure how to say it. Smiley don't miss. Right? You smiley don't miss. Who after 2 months with D changed her name to Bailey Contempt don't miss. Hey, but keep smiling, girl. Keep smiling. At least he's giving you a baby. The other girls, all he did was give him chlamydia and empty promises. And then have the nerve to ask for a ride home. So, look, little Jose touched on it earlier, but I'm sure all of you remember Dee's 30th birthday party, right?
I don't.
He's still fucking drunk from it. You don't even understand it. It was tumbleweeds and alcohol and strippers, and then I hit someone with a bat. No one knows what the fuck you were talking about for 30 minutes.
I don't either.
Or it seemed like a week. Dude, you were babbling and stuttering so much, you sounded like Chris trying to ask a girl to touch his pee. Fucking horrible. Chris, I see you shaved your vagina. Steven, you still look like Obama's pubes and penis. If Obama was lying on his stomach with his junk hanging off the side of the bed, that'd be you. You two fruity bastards. Chris and Steven. Two guys that are so far in the closet they can't reach the handle. You two, man. You two are so far in the closet, your skeletons are clenching their butt sheets. Or bone sheets, or whatever the fuck they clench to stop penetration. You're so far in the closet, you know the kids' 2014 Christmas presents. You two fruity fucks. You fruity bastards. You're so far in the closet, you just tripped over Brady and Alex. Oh, by the way, Brady and Alex is assholes and wrap around long names on it than Trojan products. Quiz. I hate them both. Hey, Jenna, Louie, how you doing, guys? I'm glad you guys took the time out to save the world through the power of music. Thank you for coming. We appreciate it. Save the babies. Splendid B-Rad. Mr. Brendan Brady. Or as he calls him, the other white meat. Brady, you chubby, racist, midget fucktard. See, I can call him a midget because I'm obviously tall. Brady's a talented hip-hop producer and many other forms of music producer. He's very, very talented. This man has exploited and made money off black men more than KFC and Colt 45 combined. D, hey, don't laugh. I'd be built to it if I didn't have responsibilities. E. Hothead son of a bitch. Even if you wanted the hide effect you smoked weed, your chunk face screams munchies. It just does. This man loves weed so much he moved to a Philly.
Good body planning. Let's invite 75 Latinos to an Irish club. And
hope no one gets fucking killed. I don't know why they fucking stereotype us anyway. Seriously, we got great girls again. You have Sarah, I have Kim, a lovely bride to be. We got engaged. Yes, yes I did. Yeah, yeah. It's real cute now, you know why? Because thank you, my ball. You look like a penis. I get to introduce her as my fiance, and in return, she introduces me as her finances. It's real cute, you know? I love you so much. She calls me baby, I call the old dude. Sarah also nicknamed me, too. She also calls him baby, Dick. Changed Lil Everett's diaper, it brought back memories of the first time her and he made love. No. Not because it was so small, but because like the baby, the first time he tried to piss on you too. You sick kid, you bastard. You are sick. Sick. No, seriously, he's the best man at my wedding. I didn't know I made a joke about myself.
What happened?
Well, it actually says two things about you and how I think of you. To even ask me to be my best man. And also that I need to get out and meet new people. White hug? Jealous. Now, you're all right, man. But you definitely ain't the Dos Equis guy. You are not the most interesting man in the world. Not even close. But you are the most hungriest man in the world. Everett hydrates by eating water buffalo. His mom has a tattoo that reads, "My son loves pie." He once ate a navigator at no particular time. He would get in touch with his feminine side if it meant he could eat the two. But then he would leave her, so he didn't have to pay her bill. He was a one-man team in his fantasy meatball league. Literally. He once traveled to Turkey, only to be disappointed there were people. He lives vicariously for a pot pie. It was said he once found a Frito in a haystack, blindfolded. Forget sharks. He has a week dedicated to just the pink starburst. 4 times a month. In the rare case he left an all-you-can-eat buffet hungry, they would close just for disappointing him. He once stood on his head to devour an upside-down pineapple cake just to give it a fighting chance. He also once walked through a McDonald's drive-thru. They gave him his order. Kafka the next time. He is the most hungriest man in the world. Stay hungry, my friend. Now, but seriously, I love all y'all. Thank you for coming out. This man, he is the man, and we should do this every fucking year for him because he's worth it. Happy birthday, man.
Drop me off. I just knew some shit. But see now, so she thought that the eggs were bullets. APB moment, shot fire, shot fire. Next thing you know, we're getting chased through the park by all the PB. I snuck home because I'm a ninja and I tend to get caught up in your shit. 3 hours later, Randy and E showed up covered in mud. Yeah, true story. Covered in mud, hiding under some damn bushes for 3 hours in the rain. While Molly PD came out doing that razor for these assholes, they come home trying to rain my car. Kiss my ass. Didn't get my clothes. I love you, man. You my dude. You come through together. I mean, I used to be the big brother. God damn. You see that picture? The one we have in the pen? She look like Thanksgiving Day Parade. BZ. We took a road trip, Smang. I don't know if you guys know me, but my girl knows it. If someone calls me at 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning, if you say, let's go to Florida, let's go to the North Pole, if you suggest a destination to me at any time of moment in my aviation, I will go. No questions asked. Nobody in my pocket. I'm gone. I will deal with the consequences when I get back. That's me. So BZ called me on a Thursday and said, I want to go to Florida. We take a 32-hour road trip to Florida. Now, BZ, if y'all don't know, we're going to BZ because he used to be fat. He's skinny now. He's stuck. He's diesel now. BZ, wait for the crowd. And everybody say, hey, give him a round of applause for BZ. Yeah. So we get to Miami. We go to the Patriots game, 2007. My boy got so drunk on South Beach the night before. 10 shots of SoCo Milan. This motherfucker threw up from the house.